Hi, hi, welcome to Karevo. This is episode 12 of CRTQ. So this is the question that we are going to solve in this CRT episode. So here we have a main function and assigned character I is equal to 0. So first I thought like it's a character and you're assigning the value of an integer. Isn't it an error? And it seems like C is too weird to consider this an error. And hence, we'll just move on to the next statement that we have for, and then we have an initialize statement here, and hence there is no initialization, it's a semicolon. I is greater than or equal to 0 is the condition, and we have I plus plus, and that is a semicolon again. So there are no statements that are being executed if this for loop condition is true. Earlier, no, we have a similar question in the last episode as well, and that we had explained it clearly that it doesn't matter whether we have statements to be executed if the condition is true or not. If we have a semicolon, it means it will just iterate the whole value of i's and it will just skip to the next iteration when it goes false, right? So when it goes false, it will come to the next statement, which is printf. So what do we have in the printf? Printf percentage d backslash n and I. Okay, seems simple. What do we do? So we have the value of I to be 0. We increment it by 1 in each iteration. As you can see here, I is greater than or equal to 0 is a true statement, and hence we'll be incrementing the value of I. So till when would we be incrementing this value of I? What is the range of this signed character value? That is what we need to find. So we have a signed character data type here. So the character can store 1 byte, that is it takes 1 byte, and the total number of bits is 8 bits, right? So how many characters or how many different numbers can be stored in this 1 byte? So that is 8 bits. So 2 power 8 numbers, that is 256 numbers, can be stored in a character, that is signed character. So what do we mean when it is signed? It could be negative as well as positive. So the range of this signed character goes from minus 128 and all the way up to 127. Why 127? Because we are also including 0 in this case, right? So the positive numbers considered being 0 plus 127, so totally 128, minus 1 to minus 128, there we have a 128, and total they add up to 256. Okay, so this is the range of a signed character. So in this for loop, as we can see here, it starts from 0, it goes on iterating. So I is equal to 1, I is equal to 2, it goes on incrementing till it reaches the maximum value, which is 127. When it reaches 127, it will be incremented by 1, still because the condition is true, it is being greater than 1, right? When it is incremented by 1, since it is the maximum value, it will just move on to the minimum value, that is, it will move on to the other end. So 127 will go to the other end, which is minus 128. And now the loop ends because the condition is false now. Minus 128 is not greater than or equal to 0. It is less than 0 because it is a negative number. And hence, in that situation, minus 128, the loop would end. And we would have to print the value of I, which is minus 128. And that is the answer to this question. Now let's move on to an IDE and verify this output. So as you can see here, we have the output as minus 128 for this line of code. This is the answer to this question. Now let's move on to the write-up session. So this is a slight variation of the question that we just solved. Let me know your answers to this question in the comment section below. If you love this video, please drop a like and comment down below if you have any questions. And please don't forget to click the subscribe button. We'll see you in the next episode of CRTQ. Until then, bye-bye.